In this video, I'm going to show you how to make your own cryptocurrency coin in less than 15 minutes. And you will be surprised how easy it is, how fast it goes, and how cheap it is. I mean, really, this stuff right here, I'm addicted to. This is more expensive than making my own coin. It's so simple. You can just copy paste exactly what I do, change a couple of things, and you have your own cryptocurrency token in 15 minutes. Welcome to FOMOtion, where I share all the crypto secrets, the best investment strategies, and the hottest new gems on the market. Today, I'm going to show you how to make your own coin. Maybe you already saw, but it's shitcoin season. And SafeMoon, for example, was such a hype. Everyone was buying SafeMoon. But SafeMoon was nothing special. Matter of fact, you can make your own SafeMoon. It's not that hard. Now, there are a couple of ways to do this. You can just Google and search for token generator. You find a template, you fill the name of your coin, how many coins do you want, what you can do with it, and then you have to pay at least one BNB. So that sucks, because one BNB is at least $600 right now. And I don't know about you, but if I want to make my own coin, it's fun, it's nice, but I'm not gonna pay $600 to make my own coin. I'm not even knowing if it's going to be something. I just want to do it. Luckily, there's also a way that's almost free. It will cost you only the gas fees of the Binance Smart Chain network. And the gas fees are just a couple of cents, maybe a couple of dollars. So that's pretty cheap, right? And I'm gonna show you how to do it. Like I said, you can just copy and paste what I do, because you have to make your own contract. And therefore you don't have to pay, because you have to pay so much money so that people already have pre-made contracts for you. Why would you pay for something like that if you can watch this YouTube video, copy paste what I do, just replace the name of my token with the name of your token, and it's done. There's only one thing you need to keep in mind, and this is important. If you're gonna watch this video, subscribe to the channel, please. It will help me a lot, and you won't miss out on anything, because I'm gonna make a lot more content about this. First step is you have to have MetaMask. MetaMask is a wallet on your computer which allows you to be on the Binance Smart Chain. You can just Google download MetaMask. You go to the MetaMask website and you can download the extension. Once you've downloaded MetaMask, you can find it here in the extensions. You need to have the Google Chrome browser on your computer. Then you have to be on the Smart Chain, and the Smart Chain doesn't come with MetaMask. You have to install it yourself. It's very simple. You can go right here, your account, you go to settings, mine is in Dutch, sorry for that. After that, you go to networks and you click add network. Here you'll find what you have to fill in. So pause the video and fill this in, exactly this. After that, you have the Binance Smart Chain ready on your MetaMask to go. So now it's time to make your own coin. Keep in mind, by the way, you have to have some BNB on it. Not a lot, but you have to pay the gas fees. If you don't know how to transfer BNB to your MetaMask wallet, I'll make a separate video about that. Leave a comment if you'd like me to make a video about it. Then, to make your own coin, go to the following website. It's called remix.ethereum.org. You will also need another tab to open this website. I'll leave a link in the description of the video so you can just copy paste it. It's called GitHub. And here you can find the contract that already exists. So you can just copy and paste it and edit it a little bit so you can make it your own coin. Once you're on this website, you click contracts, scroll down a little bit, click token, and then you click ERC20. And then the last thing you click is ERC20.sol. Now, go back to the Remix Ethereum website, and you can make a new file by clicking this icon right here, create new file. And you type in BEP-20.sol. Press enter, and you open a new file. Here you can make the contract, and just copy paste exactly what I do. The first line, type exactly what I have right here. Now go back to the GitHub website and copy exactly this link. Now go back to the Remix Ethereum site, press enter twice so you leave one blank line, and then type import, do this symbol right here, and then you paste the website. And then at the end, you type this. Then again, press enter twice to leave a blank line, type in contract, space, and there comes the name of your token. I'll call mine FOMOtion. You can call it whatever you want, of course. Let's think about this very good, because this is going to be the name of your coin. Then type is ERC20 space, and then you use this symbol right here. Press enter and type constructor. Then use this symbol. I'm Dutch, so I'm not familiar with the English terms already. And type UINT256. Then use a space and type initial supply. Then skip this, do a space, and type public space ERC20. Then again, use this symbol right here. Then use this symbol and type the name of your coin again. So I type FOMOTION, skip one, use this symbol, space, and again, use these symbols. I'm sorry, I'm not familiar with the names of the symbols. I'm a stupid Dutch guy. But here comes your ticker. So that's the short name of your coin. So mine is called FOMOTION, so I want to short it up by calling it FOMO. Then skip this and use this symbol again. Press enter, underscore, and type mint, and then type this msg.sender, comma, initial supply again. Skip this character and type this right here. Now it's time to deploy the contract. So you must be logged in on your MetaMask and make sure you're on the Binance Smart Chain. If you're not on the Binance Smart Chain, it won't work. So make sure to check if that's correct. All right. Then you go to this icon right here, and you have to check if the compiler says 0.8.1 plus commit dot blah, 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 blah. Everything you see right here. Everything you see right here should be good. Then you click compile. Then once you compile it, you go to this icon right here, and here are some things you need to check. First, the environment. It says JavaScript, whatever for script. You have to make sure this is injected Web3. Then the account. This is your account. You're logged in with MetaMask, so make sure to check if this is the correct account, but it should be all right. The gas limit is all right. Also, nothing to do about that. Double check if this contract has your token name in it. So this must be the right contract. And then you will set an initial supply. So that means how many of these tokens are going to exist. And keep in mind that if you say I want 10,000 tokens, the tokens decibels is rounded up by 18. So it means you can divide your tokens by 18. So I could have 0.00001 FOMO coin. So if you want 10,000 of your coins, or doesn't matter how many you want, you always have to put 18 extra zeros behind it. So first set how many coins you want, and then put the 18 extra zeros behind it. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 15, 16, 17, 18. So that a lot of zeros looks very interesting, but it's not what you're gonna get. Don't worry. You get the supply you set in the first place without all the extra 18 zeros. And then what you have to do is press deploy, and it's gonna make your coin. So let's click it, deploy. You're going to your MetaMask account, and your MetaMask, you see, you have to pay a little gas fees. And like I said, this is not expensive, because this is $600, this is $60, this is $6, and this is 60 cents. So this is like $3.60 what I have to pay right now. Make sure you have the right amount of gas fees and click confirm. Now it says here, creation of FOMOTION pending. And now your coin is generated, and all you have to do is click right here. You see the green mark, you click it, scroll down a little bit, and you see the transaction hash. This you can copy, and then you go to bscscan.com. You paste the transaction hash right here, and you see it's a success. Here you see from. That's your address where you paid the transaction with. And here you see interacted with to, And this is the contract address. This is the contract address of your coin. As you can see right here, this is FOMOtion. As you can see, there are 10,000 FOMO at the market right now. One address, that's me. And this is the contract address. So your coin is on the market right now. And now you're ready to scam people. No, just kidding, don't scam. Be a real good person and do something nice with this. I recommend you strongly doing that. But that's not everything. I'm gonna show you how to add it to your MetaMask and how you actually can sell this coin. So stick with me for a while because this is what a lot of people don't tell you. This is what nobody tells you, I think. So let's take another look. You can copy the contract address and then open up your MetaMask. Scroll all the way down and click add token. And then you add a custom token and you just have to paste the address right here. And it does the rest for you. You can see FOMO, 18 decibels. You click next, you click add token, and you see I have 10,000 FOMO. But now I got all the coins, so people can buy it actually, because I got them all. So what's the use of it if no one actually can pay for this, right? It's very easy to do. You just have to send some of your coins to the contract address. And therefore you have to decide how much coins do you want to keep yourself and how much coins do you want to sell. So when you added the coin at MetaMask, you go all the way down, click your coin and click send. And then here you fill in the contract address of your coin. It says you are sending the tokens to a contract address. This may result in a loss of these tokens. That's correct, because if I send them to my contract address, I can't get them back. So first, really think about how many coins you want to send, because you can't make this undone. Let's say I have 10,000 FOMO tokens. I want to send 6,000 FOMO tokens to the address. I'll fill in 6,000, click next. And I have to pay a little gas fees, of course. So that's what I'm gonna confirm right now. And then the transaction is pending. And usually this goes pretty fast, in a couple of seconds, maybe a few minutes, and then it's done. Then you are already set to sell your coin, because PancakeSwap lists your coin automatically. So if you go to PancakeSwap and you will go to trade, you can fill in your contract address right there and you can already buy your own coin. For example, I want to trade my BNB for my FOMO coin. So I'll go to select currency, I do command V, fill in the contract address, and I see my FOMO coins right here. Now, how do you know what your coin is worth exactly? Therefore, you need liquidity. It makes sure that the coin doesn't fluctuate in price too much. If I wanted to sell all my coins in once or a part of it, the price will fall down drastically. And therefore you can go to PancakeSwap and you can go to liquidity and you can add liquidity. And you have to have an input and you have to have an output. And the input, it's BNB, and the output is your coin. So you can go select currency and you select your coins once again, and it says you are the first liquidity provider. The ratio of your tokens you add will set the price of this pool. Once you are happy with the rate, click supply to review. So let's say you want to use the half of the BNB that you want to use. So I have 0.02, so I'm going for 0.01, and here I can fill in how much coins I want to add to this. So if I add one coin, it would mean that one BNB will be worth 87 FOMO tokens. If I use 11 FOMO, it will be cheaper. So that's the way you can decide how much you want your coin to be worth. And the more people provide liquidity and the more BNB you add to it, the more liquid it gets, and the price won't fluctuate as much. So in this case, you will get 1,312 FOMOs for one BNB. You have to approve it. That's with everything on PancakeSwap, every click you do, you have to approve something, you have to confirm something. That's just PancakeSwap. So that's what you have to do first. Takes a minute, so I'm gonna skip this part of the video. Once it's approved, you can press supply. You click create pool and supply. Then once again, you have to pay a little amount of gas fees. And as you can see, I don't have enough BNB at the moment, so I will provide liquidity to my coin another time. Doesn't matter. It's just an example of how you can do this. Once you provided enough liquidity to your coin, you can go to poocoin.app. You can insert your token address right here. You won't see anything in my case because I didn't provide liquidity yet. But here you can track your token, so you can see the charts, you can see what it's worth, you can see the market cap of your coin, and you can let people see what you did. And if you subscribe to the channel, I'll give you more tips about crypto. Do it now. Click right. Yeah, that's it for today. That's how you make your own coin. I hope you come up with something good. Of course, you'll need a website, you need a good Telegram group, you need a Reddit subreddit, you need a Medium article. So once again, don't go and just scam and rug pull people. It's enough happening already. But this is the way you do it. Like I said, it's easy, it's fast, it's cheap. What else do you want? That's it for today. I will say like the video if you like the video. If you have an opinion about something, leave a comment, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.